So you have a unique situation from most other dentists in the room as to how your practice is run and what you do in your practice, specifically with insurance and PPO, where everybody else seems to be wanting to run away from insurance. You've embraced it, you've built systems on it. So let's talk about, tell me about, first of all, your practice, to give people a perspective of what your practice looks like, how big it is, how long you've been in practice, how many people. So give me an overview of what your practice looks like and how it operates.
Certainly.
Okay. And you can talk to me.
Oh, perfect. I'm John Busby. I'm the managing partner of a dental group in Madison, Wisconsin called Affiliated Dentists. We have 6 doctors, 2 locations, 40-plus employees. The process of evolving Affiliated to where it's at today started in the middle 80s. I got out of the military, bought a practice on the east side of town, was an associate on the west side of town. We grew, we bought, we merged, we added people. I should also say that when I got out of the military, the first practice I bought was me and 3 part-time people. We've evolved significantly because we put systems in place. Systems in place to market, to manage, to organize, to get bigger and grow better. Any organization that you have never stops improving. Fortunately, I'm in a situation I don't practice clinically any longer. I spend my time being the managing partner, which is somewhat of a unique role in that I have time to put systems in place to encourage people to be better. Part of that is, in a very simple analysis, you want to hire very good people, encourage them to be better, pay them, compensate them appropriately, create an environment where the feeling is magic. I had a patient come in and one day described our organization as, it seems like it's somebody's birthday every day. If you have that, it becomes electric to your staff, to the doctors, to patients. And that's what you want to have. Have it be fun. Hire good people, let them know they're part of the organization, and delegate. It's that simple. There's not enough time in the day to do everything in a dental office. Setting up systems, managing, organizing is what I do. I actually enjoy it. I had an idea about 15 years ago that PPOs have the potential to be a positive force in the dental world. That was certainly contrary to conventional wisdom. I felt very strongly about it. I actually went to Northwestern University and got an MBA. My thesis is and was successful management of a dental practice in a PPO environment. We chose to, first of all, encourage PPOs, encourage our participation. The magic thing that we do is as we get bigger and bigger, I have a management company that increases the fee schedule that doctors get from PPOs. I believe the magic is that PPOs do not want to negotiate. They have a margin or a range that they are willing to negotiate. If you create a unique selling position and tell them how your relationship with them can be a positive and encourage them to give you an enhanced fee schedule, that's a nice way of saying I want a salary increase, it becomes available. The thing that is absolutely magic about this, the difference between the fee that you accept, the fee that you're doing now, and the enhanced fee schedule is 100% profit. The PPO does all your marketing, they drive people to your door. The other magic thing is PPO patients are just like anybody else. They exceed their maximums, they have non-covered procedures, they have cosmetic things, they are just regular people that need dental care. For some reason, the dental world does not understand that concept, and that's what my role is. I try to let people be aware PPOs can be a positive force in your life. It works real well. And if you're not involved in PPO participation, the mega trend that's happening is PPOs are going to dominate the dental insurance world. And if you're on the wrong end of this and all those patients are in somebody else's office and you come to the party late, you are going to have a significant problem.
Yeah.
That's where I exist.
Give me an idea, if you don't mind sharing, the size of your practice as far as how many employees you have, how many associates you have, and then just to give perspective, what billings are, you know, on an annual basis, if you don't mind sharing.
Sure. We have 5 doctors that are incredibly efficient. You need to hire efficient people that work hard, but still have the warm fuzzies that can relate to people. You never need to lose track of the goal that patients make everything possible. We have 9 administrative people. We have 19 hygienists. We have a very big organization in 2 offices. By having 19 hygienists, you have to manage the heck out of hygiene departments. It's just another vehicle to encourage growth. We bill in the $6 to $8 million range. When you do that, every organization needs to understand expenses and your profit margins. In the PPO world, if you have an efficient organization where your overhead is in the 50s, you can take a 10% cut. If you get more than 15%, that's where I have a concern. But if you have a 55% overhead, you have a 45% margin, and every business in America would love to have their margin reduced to only 30%. The advantage we have in the dental world is we have huge profit margins. I don't have to apologize for that at all. I'm happy to live in that world and maximize our profit margins as much as we can.
With Jerry Jones Direct, with ClearPath, especially, you know, in Mastermind, not going to the story of, you know, Jerry started it off and needed people, you know.
Sure.
I don't want to hear that story.
Well, that nobody wants to hear that because they're on the wrong end of that one.
Regardless of that, and even friendship and so forth, and knowing Jerry, you still have a personal motivation for wanting to get involved and what you're looking. Why? What was your personal motivation or nudge, if you will, that said this is something valuable that you can take away? I mean, what was your reasoning in your mind for getting involved with Jerry in this group and then sticking with it so long? Because I want you to talk about the fact of how long you've been with this group, because that's important.
I started with Jerry Jones in 2002. I wanted to do a newsletter. At the time, that was Jerry's niche. That's what he did very well. Based on that, we have a concept at Affiliated Dentists. We only do business with friends. Jerry became a business associate. Based on success, we started doing more things with Jerry. Freestanding insert, mostly print material. Jerry is a very positive force, very likable person that gets results. He writes copy that gets results. Based on success, we started doing more things with Jerry. He started an organization called the Clear Path Society. I'm happy to say I was one of the inaugural members. I'm also very happy to say I've been to every mastermind meeting that they've had. I come because personally they're fun. Everybody comes from a different background, a different location, rural, urban, big practice, group practice, solo practice, but our problems and issues are all the same, just wrapped in a different package. So it's not only a mentally stimulating environment because everybody has a unique story to tell, because many times people keep coming back, you get to hear the first chapter, how it evolved, how they solved their problems, and how it continues on. I think everybody wants to see a success formula. People that are here are generally dynamic people that choose to take time out of their day. They just have a different story than yours, but their story can be applied to your situation. It's just how you choose to do it. Many of the people that are here are just functioning on an incredibly high level. And if you can take back to your dental practice some of the ideas, it's absolutely incredible. The camaraderie that you have with these people, you got fun people that are doing stuff. You always want to have the ability to pair yourself with people that are doing things that are very positive in their life and in their dental practice.
You made a comment earlier that I would like you to speak to. And this, I know, is opinion, it's conjecture on your part, but I think it's valuable because of the longevity you have with the group and the consistency you have in attending the group. But you made the comment about seeing people stay as members, but then not come and participate and so forth. If you can speak to what's getting in the way? Why do you think that people do that? What's the mindset of that doctor?
Sure.
You know,
I have the ability, I have a lot of time flexibility because I don't work clinically. Any clinician not only is trying to be productive and run systems, they have to manage their personal life, their home life balance. Anytime you leave the office, your productivity hits zero. But it's important to come to events to find out what's going on, find out what trends are going on in the world, and trying to stay ahead of those trends. By having like-minded people with similar problems, a lot of those issues can be discussed, resolved, and many times the issue is, we do this in our office. Well, why do you do that? Well, because this works and that works. Really, I've tried this and that hasn't worked, and you're able to work out issues to an appropriate end result. Any practitioner needs to devote time not only to clinical skills, I devote time to management and business skills. This is certainly a place for that, marketing ideas and generally management of a dental practice. Just a great environment to learn.
And there's a commonality, not just in this mastermind group, but in many mastermind groups that I get involved in. Because as you started off and said so eloquently, is that life basically gets in the way, the business gets in the way. I can't take time away because I got to be there to run it, I got to be there to manage it and so forth. But there seems to be a commonality, and I'd like you to speak to this and share this for people who view this. The commonality that I have seen is those that make the commitment to a mastermind group and those that make the commitment to be involved physically, mentally, emotionally in that mastermind group see their business and lifestyle changes to the fact of, take for example, yourself, Sean Tarpening, and Jerry, and let me think who else, even Dr. Rader, and so, but you can look at the room as an observer and go, there's a guy who's got his business in order, there's a guy who's got his business in order, and there's a guy who is reading the texts, and you know what I'm getting at? If you can speak to that about how this group and being involved, because this is what I want to get people to understand,
sure,
is if you're going to make the commitment, be all in, and if you're all in, here's what you get. So if you can talk to that a little
certainly
bit.
Certainly. Many times everybody comes with a different personality, different mindset. In my life, I usually don't do things halfway. I actually do things to excess, which is somewhat of a joke in my family. But this is just another vehicle to be involved. If you're connected, if you're committed, it's very easy to say when it's announced, you've got 2 months in advance to put on your calendar. Jerry recognizes that everybody's busy. These are usually on Fridays and Saturdays. If you can slice a portion of your business day, and many doctors don't work on Fridays, so if you make the commitment is easy to say, well, there's an event on such and such a date in such and such a city. Just about everybody flies in. So it is a commitment of time and some level of resources, but what you get on the return on your investment, I've always been very comfortable with. The ideas of like-minded people giving you creativity and really energizing where you're at in the dental world is fun. If you can mix being fun with learning, meeting people, and sharing stories on success, that's absolutely incredible. And the people that fill all the seats at these events are really dynamic people. And if you surround yourself with dynamic people and the willingness to ask questions, get answers from people that are truly doing significant things in the dental world. That's the reason why people should be at a Jerry Jones mastermind event, because there truly are a lot of masterminds willing to share ideas.
And if you could, and last question would be, is if you can talk to the transformation that you see of members who actually are all in, as to what happens to their practice, what happens to their life, what happens to their family, what happens to them in general.
The interesting thing, I sort of divide our group into thirds, a third that come all the time, a third that come much of the time, but not all the time, and a third that are new. I think a new person comes in and they're so overwhelmed by the creativity and the energy in the room. Either they get drawn in like, this is a group that I need to be in, that I want to be in, and share this with a lot of other people. Unfortunately, in the dental world, just as any business, there are some people that don't find that balance. I hate to say can't figure it out, and that's fine. The world's made of a lot of people. People that are here are generally successful. Surrounding yourself with successful people, hearing successful ideas, puts you on the success track. Unfortunately, sometimes people are their own roadblock to success. This is not a place to be at if you do not want to be successful, because the success just vibrates in the room, and it's very stimulating. It's a ton of fun.